guys, what's up? Check out this little thing. This is the 3V gear Subrosa, okay? And right now at the time of recording this, this sucker costs $45. 45 bucks. Now look at the little aesthetic, okay? I've got the tag on here because I have not, I haven't used this as a daily carry. This isn't like me after I've rucked about with this for a while. This is just me going like, let's talk about how this bag is made. Let's talk about the features and what it's actually like. And then let's compare it to like what it's looking like. It could work like a GORUCK bag. This is $45. The GORUCK is $295 for the GR1. Okay, this has a lot more pockets than that. Let's just see, let me just walk through this bag with you and I'll show you the things that would feel fine and that would feel shitty on this bag. So our main fabric here is a 600D PVC backed polyester. So we're saving a ton on not using Cordura. But look at this PVC backing that they've got on it. It feels like it's a actual separate thin. I don't know if it's on the actual material itself. It's like glued onto the material, or if it is just a separate sheet that they've sort of sewn in behind it. But that gives you some extra protection from the elements, right? Cordura is an amazing fabric. This is not Cordura. You can feel the sort of thinness of this guy, but it's, you know, with that PVC backing, it feels sort of robust. Gotta mention this, by the way. They took a little moment to put a little sort of neoprene wrapping on their handle, which, like, I know this bag, there's a lot to talk about in this bag, but that little handle, it just feels kind of nice. Kind of feels nice in the hand. All right, now we don't have any Molly over here, but we've got Molly strapping on the side so you can clip in some of your accessories if you wanted. I'll tell you where you're gonna feel some of the cheapness on this bag, because at $45, obviously some of the stuff's gonna feel cheap. This video is really about, like, could you feel great using this bag and save a fortune not going for GORUCK? And where you're gonna feel that is on the webbing here is this, it's like, it feels like a cheap, you hear that? You're gonna feel that, right? The straps themselves, like, these are fine, and I like the look. Look, it just looks like a GORUCK strap, right? Like a cheap version of a GORUCK strap. It feels good. It's got mesh underneath it. And so the bag, I'm 5'10", 190 or so pounds, right? The bag just kind of like has a nice size. It's locked in. The straps feel good, but adjusting that, I think we could do better than this 3V. But for 45 bucks, they're cutting corners. They're just going with whatever's literal cheapest. So their focus isn't on what works the best. It's on, let me restate that. They're in the tension between what works enough and what saves us the money so that they can pass the savings onto you. Now you can see the back of this bag here. We have this sort of like injection molded thing. It's not unpleasant. It's kind of nice. Vini, Vidi, Vici. For me, this is a little bit of like a, it's a little bit, I don't know, it's almost kind of like cheesy in some ways, right? Really not my style, sort of over the top, like expressing at you, like, this is what we're about. Every day matters. It's like live, laugh, love. Or whatever. I know that these actually, it's like this amazing, like, old school, like, warrior thing. It's awesome. But to me, just not knowing and about that and not being a warrior, like, well, I am a fucking warrior, first of all. Second of all, it's just not my style. By the way, there's some Velcro here that, like, you can put stuff back here. I thought this might be the laptop compartment, and then I was bummed because there's obviously no weatherproofness for your stuff there, but it's not. There's a laptop space inside. Just another spot to, you know, put something. Now, another thing on this bag that is not so bad are the zippers. Like, they're, you know, at this price, they're not YKK zippers. They're just, you know, whatever they can get for the price. And they've sewn them in, just like GORUCK does, and a lot of bag companies, where the teeth are sort of hidden inside, right? You see, the teeth are on the inside of the bag, and they're large. They're number 10 size zippers. They actually feel like they're plastic and not metal. I'm not sure. But they move well, you know? They feel good. They've got a definitely a cheap feeling zipper pull. I don't like the zipper pulls because the tininess, I bet I could, if I really wanted to, I could probably pull this thing out through the gap in the zipper thing. Harder than I thought it was gonna be. But this really thin string, this is an easy place to upgrade this to make it just feel a little more robust, because it definitely feels thin. Okay, but the zippers are kind of nice. And speaking of which, we've got a quick access right here, going at a little bit of that angle to give it a little bit of a vibe. You can feel that PVC backing on this sucker. I put my glasses case in here. You've got a little key clip in there. That's the pocket for just like throw stuff into. Then you have a front panel, which is for some organization. It looks like it goes down further on one side than on the other for some reason. I've thrown my notebook just in there. It's a little organization panel. You've got some pen stuff. You've got a place that just goes down to here to throw some stuff up top. It's nice. You've got a little mesh guy down here. It's always nice to have a little organization panel. My bummer here is I don't like this fabric, and I dislike the elastic that they're lining the tops of this with, just because, like, and actually this piece of string is from the stitching, right? So this is the kind of thing that you'll get for in a $45 bag. It's like, this is just run off of a mill in China, off the line somewhere. I'm assuming, 3V guys, tell me if we're wrong. So they're saving that money, working things out in China, and it just doesn't feel like the best quality, but it'll get all the jobs done. I have a worry about how long it will last, right? For me, I tend to be a consumer of the, like, you will get what you pay for variety, right? And I really like being able to pay a little bit more on a bag that then I just sell out to, and it's not gonna let me down, and I'm stuck with it for a long time. But that relationship is strong. This is like going for cheaper sort of stuff means I can afford it now and I can get a look that's kind of nice. Like, I bet if they're selling these in Walmart, I bet these things sell like fucking hotcakes. But the, you know, getting stuff in and out of that organization panel, for example, like over time, that's just gonna, it feels like it's gonna wear through. Just like one little area is gonna like come loose, or like one of the stitching falls off, and then that, like, it doesn't ruin everything. It just makes it look funky. That kind of stuff's always a bummer to me. I tend not to like it. Now, great feature of this bag. I don't know what it is, but like being able to open a bag full on clamshell just really makes it feel more quality. I think these guys are doing something very interesting in doing, like, here, what are people liking in that professional, tactical, semi-pro, tactical sort of thing? And let's just do that at scale for the making it for a price that most of America can afford. Okay, so in here, I've got my Peak Designs tech pouch, okay? Now, I'll put a link in the description below at this time code for pouches, because in a bag like this, you're gonna need pouches likely. This one's for sure one of my favorites ever. Even though it's like a big brick, it's a thicker, I don't like this size. I want it to be thinner. I want multiple thinner ones, but that's just me. This thing has everything in it. So I'll put a link in the description below to my favorite pouches. This one, including this one and others. Right now, Peak is doing these just in Kickstarter, so I don't know if you can get them separately. I think right now you can only get it if you do the whole Peak thing when you do the travel bag, but in the future, these are gonna be available, and you might be watching this in the future. Okay, so I've just thrown my water bottle in here. I'll put that over there, my Kundalini Tantra, just because you guys, you're an energetic being. Right? Harness that shit. Place it in the right direction and harness it for your intentions and your sexuality and your relationship with your baby. Get into it. I don't know if you know this about me, but I'm kind of a weirdo mystic, or a bit like an enthusiast. I'm a mystic enthusiast. That's not what we're talking about today. Here's the laptop compartment back here, okay? Just a simple thing, not raised up off the bottom of the bag. You kind of can't, the size is a little small for that. And here's one of the bummers, is just getting this in and out. It's because mine's a 15-inch laptop, and because this comes up so high on the bag, you've just got this space here to try to get your lip out of. On this, it's not that bad. I've seen lots of bags that are a lot worse than this. Got a little Velcro with elastic thing that goes over there. I never use those, by the way. I always just kind of throw that down like that. But we got a nice little size. This is the size of the Evergood CPL 24. This is a nice little daily carry size. I think essentials of the design on this are great. And when I think of essentials, I just think of size and proportions, right? I think it's a great looking size and proportion. I think this is a little bit of a plain looking on the front. Something about this feels like it'd be awesome if they had like a little patch right here or a little piece of Velcro right here. That would really set this off as like a, whoa, that's like a cool bag. Like just like that one side of the Velcro, and it like could come with a patch of theirs or whatever. But for $45, you kind of get a lot. You get those basics right now. Again, I think that organization panel is going to break down. I think there's a chance these zippers, always a chance. Zippers go all the time on bags. And once a zipper goes on a bag, like you can't really use it anymore. But for $45, this ends up feeling like, hey man, you want to spend $45 and get a bag that's going to last you like a year or two. I think it'll lose some of its shape over time, though it's got that PVC backing. Like the question is like, how quick until this starts to feel so dumpy that like, I don't even want to use it anymore. And then you're like, well, it's just $45 to get another one. And now they have a new version with the Velcro thing or something like that. So it's a little more consumeristic, a little more fast fashion. And that's just something to me that's like, I don't like that much, but if you treat it well, it's probably gonna last like a little while. Now, let's compare this to two bags. First of all, the GORUCK GR1. I've done a whole video on this one. I'll put in the link in the description below at this time code. All right, first thing you're gonna notice is just the thickness of the material. This thing is like, they always say it's like bomb proof, right? It does, it feels really like you can just huck this around. You can put your valuables in here and still throw it around. Then you're gonna notice the zipper pulls. I love these zipper pulls, and the zippers feel like oiled. They feel like machines in comparison to that other stuff we were just looking at, right? So you're gonna feel that on every single interaction on this bag. You're also gonna feel in every single interaction on this bag that there's only basically one pocket, right? The outside of the bag, we have this guy. Then inside, we do have these two right here, right? So you do have simple, minimal stuff. And the bag is sort of designed for you to be able to modularly set this up. Add a Molly pouch right here. Add a Molly pouch right here if you want. Something on the sides. I don't like adding Molly pouches on the outside at all because it really compromises the look of the bag to me. Okay, you're also gonna notice this is, it's a little bit bigger. Obviously, got a little more capacity. This is a GR1 21 liter, right? So the GR0, I think, is one that might be more similar to that size. And so to give you a sense of sizing here, it works effectively the same. All your stuff's a lot more protected. And that protection, like even in these, in like this, the mesh that's over here is just feels solid, it feels thick. So every interaction on this bag, every time you open up this pocket and get into it, every time you see this little thing here and it's printed on this like thick, like nice, it just, it's like, oh, this is the genuine artifact. Bonus on this guy is when you get into your laptop, you don't need to get into the bag. You can just pull it out from here. And it's what they call their bomb-proof laptop compartment, right? Which is just, it's like not really even pulled off the bottom of the bag. That's one of the bummers. Some of you probably worried about that. I'm not. I don't throw my bag around very much. But the solid plate on the back, everything about the material keeps your laptop like extremely safe in comparison. You're also gonna notice these straps. They're thick and rigid at first until you break them in over time. And they just start to mold to your body. Guys that I know who've committed to GORUCK a long time ago, they still use that same bag, that same GORUCK bag, normally a GR1, and they're like world travelers, most of them. And they're just still as adamant as ever. Like, nope, this is the best bag I ever got. You should stop everything and just go with GORUCK, Chase. I'm not that fanatic about these guys. I think they're very expensive. I think they're not very accessible. I think they leave something to be desired in terms of organization, right? I think they could totally, they're clearly like straddling this market of like very, very, you know, go do one of the ruck off things and like go get hurt with your friends and feel the pain of life and exult in it, be an army, military type person. And then also like, it's like, oh, I need my laptop and I need to bring what I need to for work because I have a job and I have to earn money and this is the job that I do. So it's like this mix of both of those. And the way that they're mixing those is they're leaning more towards like, we use our bags for rucking around, but they're developing tons of products for like daily carry for city folk. And that's why those of us who dig this brand and go for these products, that's why we like it so much, because it makes we're like hiring their authenticity, right? And that's what you get with this pack. Like, you get honest authenticity. Like, you get a real well-made thing from a real passionate group of people who are not making compromises in what they believe a bag should be. I think that's pretty fucking killer, right? I always love stories like that, and I always want companies like this to succeed, right? And then there's the Evergood CPL, which to me is like, this is right up my alley. This is, it takes all the stuff about GORUCK, and it says like, yeah, I get it. But you're a little old school, like you're little, like we've come up with new shit since then. It's not tech, it's not like future oriented in the way that this is, because this is still utterly stylish, clear, classic, minimal, right? A little more ready for the metro to me. It doesn't scream tactical or tactical, right? It just has a kind of minimal aesthetic, but the quality of the materials is all still there in terms of how long it's gonna last, what it feels like to use, getting into it, right? Does this look familiar? Same panel structure as the GORUCK, right? Just filled up, and then we've got this little thing right here. Same exact kind of thing. Great mesh here as well. They add this little guy, which is the which is like a Duraflex material or something. I don't know. I love this. This is amazing. It is not their laptop compartment, right? The laptop is back here. So you fit your laptop in. It's a little more, I like this. This is like killer. Laptop goes in and out. Then you have this, so you can take any heavy stuff or any things that you want, keep it right up against the back of your bag. Now, one of the challenges with this bag is you only have one pocket up here on the front. Now, I suspect in the future they're gonna make this with one of those Duraflex things that we saw on the back through the middle with a sewn-in split on it, right? So that I can throw my phone up in the top one, glasses in the other one, and then any other bigger things out there. I think that's, they might not, but I think that's what's needed in this bag. It's just a little bit of divider right there. Excellent straps. Everything about this bag feels like a little more, okay, it's like GORUCK. I don't want to say Elon Musk-y, but it feels more Elon Musk-y. It feels more considered. It feels more thoughtful. It feels more Buckminster Fuller to me. If GORUCK is a little more country south of like you know, the American South and military, Evergoods is a little more like, I don't know, Minnesota outdoors, Buckminster Fuller. Like intelligent designy. Now, not to say that this is smarter than that. It feels a little smarter though. Like a little smarter, and it kind of knows it. I don't know. Like I'm getting real wordy about this. I mean, this started with a video about a $45 bag. But this is how I think about these products, right? And so when you have this for $45 and it gets you like aesthetically, it gets you basically most of the way there. What you're gonna notice is, what you're in the conversation of is like, are your hands gonna notice it? I don't think they're gonna notice it very much for a while at least. They will notice it, like I said, on this one little bit right here, and zipping, like, you know, cinching that in. But like for $45, it's kind of nice, right? Like I would much rather see people into bags like these, just because for you to put your money where your mouth is into an artifact and a tool that is really purpose designed for you. Like, I know for us to spend $200 on a bag or even more than that in the GORUCK case, like you're really kind of committing to something. And I just think commitments like that, when they're to a product that matters, that like is worth the commitment, it kind of changes your life. It kind of does. I'm in this hard spot between like going like, you know, this is fine. Like, go buy one of these bags. And also wanting to protect you from like 3 months from now going like, oh dude, my strap fell completely off, which I just don't know if it would happen, right? I'm feeling it, I'm looking at it, and I'm going like, no, this thing's like, I think it's fairly solid. It's got the PVC backing on the front and the sides. Like, they go, there's a lot of build here for $45. But I would recommend, you know, going a little more probably and getting the whole thing. The truth is, anybody who's buying that bag probably isn't watching this video. They're probably getting that bag like straight out of in store somewhere. Okay, so there's me ranting and raving about some bag shit. How are you still watching now? You're one of my favorite people in the entire world. You must already be a subscriber. If you're not, please subscribe because you belong in our bag community of weirdos, right? And I'm putting together a community on this YouTube channel of people who are interested in living a more considered life, in not contributing as much to that plastic island in the ocean that literally is just plastic that has found itself and gathered itself together like a planet of plastic in the ocean. Not to be contributing to that so much, to be letting our dollar be our vote, and to supporting, like, sometimes that means supporting independent manufacturers and makers and stuff like that. And sometimes that just means, you know, using every little bit of money you have in the right way. And so hopefully this gives you a sense of that. Of that 3V gear bag, and you were like actually looking for it, and you're like, you're gonna do it. I wanna hear how it goes. And I wish you all the best, because what we carry, how we carry our tools, the tools that we use in our life, I mean, these things matter a great deal in how we live and in how smoothly our life goes. And I care a great deal. Thank you guys for watching. Talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
Bagworks.co. ChaseReeves.net. Those are the websites.
I guess those are the websites. Yeah, I guess wanting so. Us to, I guess, go check out what he's up to or something like that. Yeah, looks nice.